You know when you got the county in pocket, you start filling for the bread.
Oh, 6, 7, 25, 26.
Ain't no 20 out here, bro. Oh, that's the 20th. Step on it.
See, look, when you get into this money, you let your man hold the
Yeah, they really thought Lachlan was going to lose. Lachlan got the jersey.
Wait, they got New Jersey?
Yeah,
they got New Jersey. What is it?
BLMAS?
It's called the Bishop Lachlan Memorial High School.
Is it
My name is Danny Harris, and I welcome all of you to the 2016 PSAL Basketball Championships press conference. So, the PSAL in Madison Square Garden have a rich history of hosting PSAL championship games. In fact, there's no other arena, no other court that has hosted more PSAL basketball championships. In fact, the PSAL in Madison Square Garden hosted the first basketball championship long before most of you were born. So we're going to start off by getting this party started by introducing and first congratulating all of the teams who have made it this far. So first, I'd like to congratulate the team from South Shore. Where are you? The team from South Shore, ladies. Congratulations. I'd then like to thank and congratulate the team from Francis Lewis. Where are you? The Francis Lewis ladies. I want to congratulate the team from Thomas Jefferson, the Thomas Jefferson young man. Where are you? And I'd like to congratulate the team from Abraham Lincoln. Where are you guys? Congratulations. Congratulations on making it this far. But also, just when you value something, you tend to treat it with a little bit more respect. So I want to tell you, I don't know the exact numbers on how much money it costs to open these doors on Saturday and to pay all the people that will come and put the floor down and to pay all the people who will go around the stands to make sure that you're playing in a safe environment, turn on those lights, put your names on the scoreboard, pay the salary of Executive Director Donald Douglas. I don't know how much it is, but I do know that it's very valuable. And everyone that will be coming on Saturday to prepare this court for you is for you to have the opportunity to have a once-in-a-lifetime experience. And we want you to value that. We want you to know how valuable it is. We want you to know how much hard work you've put in. We want you to know how much hard work the staff of everyone in the PSAL has put in just to give you four teams this wonderful opportunity. So we don't want you to ever forget that. Just to set the stage for the two games that we have here. First, the girls' games. We have a battle of two past champions, the last two champions, Francis Lewis in 2014, and of course, South Shore in 2015. Yeah. Who's gonna win the championship this year and make it two out of three of the last 3 years? Then on the boys' side, we have Abraham Lincoln that has a rich history of winning championships. I think 6 or 8 out of the last 14 years. Thomas Jefferson, who has been the epitome of excellence over the last, getting to the championship game, I think, what is this, the fourth year? Four out of the last five. So are they gonna win their first championship? Since unfortunately, I don't remember the last year, but I know that they're, I'm not trying to be, because I had written it down, I'm not trying to be rude, but these guys have been fighting. This team that won a JV championship has been together for 4 years, and I tell you that they're gonna be coming strong because they wanna win that championship. So we have two great stories, but the team stories, the individual stories, we're gonna leave it to the coaches. And it's a tale of two teams. We talk about Thomas Jefferson making it to 4 out of the 5 last championship games. Coming into this year, after a terrific summer, you had Shamorie Ponds, who had all kinds of expectations put on his shoulder, saying he had a great summer. He's coming into the year. He had a target on his back because everybody knew about him. He lived up to every bit of those expectations, averaging 28 points a game during the year. I believe bringing home the New York State Mr. Basketball. He's going to St. John's next year. His backcourt mate, Rasheem Dunn, averaging, I believe, 16 points a game, going to St. Francis College. These are the personal stories. Mr. Faison leading the team in rebounds. You have all kinds of personal stories, a great team effort. I think this is the first time in however long I can remember that 4 out of the 5 starters on that team averaged double figures. So they're a team. They're led by their coach. Coach Pollard was a PSAL guy going to the high. He went on to West Virginia, competed at a high level. And then we move over to Lincoln. Lincoln, coming into this year, it was the first year they got knocked out of the playoffs in the quarterfinals the year before. They were a young team. People maybe didn't expect that much. But they came together as a team. 4 out of their 5 starters. Kaheem Brown. I know they're going to miss the young man who got hurt. Rakeem Felder. They have a young man, Selassie Bourne, a point guard, averaging 11 points a game. 4 out of 5 of their starters are averaging 10 points a game or more. So they're a true team coming into this game. It's gonna be a true battle for who wins Brooklyn. They've played each other 3 times this year already, so they're very familiar with one another. But they're gonna be coming to play. So we're looking forward to it, and we hope it's gonna be as exciting as it is prepping for the game. Now I'd like to introduce the coach for Thomas Jefferson, who has been here the last 4 out of 5 years. Coach Lawrence Pollard, please come up. Let's give it up.
Hello, everybody. My Jimmy, the old guy, took care of Jimmy for the national championship.
system all game to take us to the Rose Bowl, Florida State, right there in here, Mr. Man? So you, where's your orange tie? I ain't never played that for you, right? But anyway, hey guys, I'm just happy to be here. I mean, you guys enjoy it because it's not promised to you guys. We're playing the Garden for. He's like Darren said, like we're brothers. Like Darren, Tiny, myself, we roomed on the road AAU, and I slept in the room. I don't know who was snoring louder, him or Tiny. Remember that Darren in Milwaukee, and so we have a close relationship. We like brothers. We grew up together. I've been a Boys High guy. Now I'm an OrangeWave guy. Tiny's a Lincoln guy. If you don't know about any, if you know anything about boys and girls, we don't like Lincoln. And I don't, like I told Tiny, I don't like Lincoln. But that's on the court. After the court, Tiny lives across the street from me. I mean, we hang out, we friends. But during the course of the game, we don't like each other. But that's not personal. We just battle. We just kind of like two brothers that want to beat each other. It's nothing personal. So you guys on Saturday, you battle. After that, you move on. You become friends, which you all are now. And we move on. But Saturday, it should be a tough game. And you guys should be happy to be here. Last thing I'm going to say, we was in the City of Palms this year. They was talking about Shamorie, one of the only 10 players in the history of the tournament to average 30. And the next thing he said, they play in the coolest league in the country while they play the championship in Madison Square Garden. So people around the country are going to be watching this game. People around the country know what's going on here. So a lot of people are jealous that they don't get to play in Madison Square Garden. So appreciate this, guys. Enjoy it, because you know, we've been here for the last 5 years. A lot of guys wish they had a chance to get their hands on these balls. You have to watch what you say around these guys. But again, also I want to thank the PSL for putting up with us. I didn't want to speak this much. My new motto is say less and do more. All right, say less and do more. Again, I want to thank Coach Gustin, Grimmer, the referees, for putting up with myself and Coach Morton. We could be two bozos at times, but we don't mean any harm, guys. We want to instill the fight and the fire in us to get you to places where we are now. So you guys can do this. I remember when I was playing my first junior high school tournament, Coach Gustin ran that tournament at 275 in Nazareth High School. This had to be, 83, 84, and he took Rob Phelps and those guys in Nazareth and changed their lives. And somebody's gonna have to do this another 10 years. Shamorie, Keith Spellman, you guys. I can't do this forever. You know, I used to have waves and a lot of hair, and I'm gray. You know, I'm McDonald, we used to playing Soul in the Hole together. I want to go back to playing ball. Coach Gustin still plays the 50 and over league. Tell him, Coach Gustin, I want to get back in shape and start playing. So hopefully one of you guys can come back and take over for this like Coach Moore did at Lincoln. You know, I mean, it's nothing better than watching a guy like him that played at Lincoln, Roof at the High, Ron and Cardozo that played at and coaching the Alma Mater's championships. So again, thanks again. Say less and do more, guys. So that means on social media, don't say anything. Whatever you got to say, leave it on the court. Say it on the court on Saturday. All right?
Come on, guys. All right, gentlemen, this way. More. One, two, last one, three.
Stay. Look this way.
Got a Tyrone?
Get in, Mally. Get in. Now get in.
All right, boys, just wait.
Move over some.
Right here.
Guys, all eyes forward. Let's go. All eyes forward.
All right, boys, right here.
Watch him, mom.
I can't see you.
We're taking it. Number 13. Lose it. feel me?
We know that.
No one.
You know that.
Mally, take your camera. Shut up, Rolly. Shut up, Rolly, one time. Hold on, hold on, hold on.
Let me orchestrate this. Let me orchestrate this, you heard?
Uh-huh.
Rolly, you know Tommy Tommy.
Okay, you know that.
We gonna see you at the garden.
No, no.
Okay, Lou, talk to him, Lou. Go to Marcus. Go to Marcus. Yo, Mally, Mally, what's happening?
Emma and Javi, what's up?
What'd
you say? Shout out to my man Jabi and Emma, you know. My two favorite L House people. It's all love though.
Go to Marcus, what happened?
Go to Marcus.
Go to Marcus. Go to Marcus. Go to Marcus. Go to Marcus.
Yo, boss my Lou.
We ain't gonna talk about it.
I ain't gonna spit no freestyle for y'all.
Why not, man?
What time, man? Get my outfit for me.
Let me get a water.
Thirsty?
Thirsty
on a Thursday.
Spit that
right now.
I said, them Lincoln boys in town. So you know it's going down. I ain't gonna stop. Come on. The crown.
Rwanda, rewind the bat.
I don't even remember what I said. I don't know what I said. I didn't say nothing, but I thought it was hot. Huh? I said, now I'm going to talk disrespectful. Three stripes.
Oh,
listen,
hi, Tiny.
I don't like Nike. Uh-huh. Under Armour's my sneakers.
Ooh.
Ooh. Okay. I said, hold on.
Yo, hold on.
I said, listen, my coach don't like Tiny because his name is Polar.
His name is Polar.
Nah. It's all love, man. I'm going to see you at the garden, man.
Over here. looking, 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 looking for revenge.
Game time, man.
You in it for the minute.
I got a feeling.
I'm
not for the dollar. I got a minute. I said, do it for the man.
You do it for the man.
I'm
like a
job.
I'm
like
you know, turn up part two, championship Saturday. You know how I go.
I come down Southwest with that ooh wop, and they never read all of it.
Do it.
Going to the garden, man. I mean, let's do it. That's it. We're going to take care of business. We here. Live action at 12. Video be square.
My government make him do the running, man. Somebody pass him running, man.
What that gun?
We never understand. Had to get back in my ways.
Driving on your lane.
Had to get back in my ways.
Over 6K. Had to get back in my ways. Street for you like a camper. And I ball hard like the answer. Rose gold, this one wasn't.
Had to get back in my ways.
Sleeping like a
Curtis Smith.
Concert tonight?
Yes. That's it.
I'll be here till 12 o'clock. Come by later. Great way to make a living, man. Yeah.
It's 11 o'clock, man. We be on the court in a minute.
So 10 is 18, 35 is 18, 15 is 18.
13 is 18, 25 is 18. Jordan 18. Jordan 18. Yeah, it's 25 is 25. Hey, coach, that one in the village is about 14th Street.
Man,
me.
Put this on.
Remind me that you're wide, Coach. Right?
I'm gonna put this on your belt.
I know you used to being wild up on the. You know what I'm saying? You know you look real comfortable wearing that wide, Coach. Big dog.
You got the young lady gave you a pass for Coach Jefferson.
Yeah.
She said give it to me because he's out there now. So
hey, yo, where's that pass, Bonnet? Take that to sell.
I think that came from Brady. That one is chip.
All right, let's go, everybody, right here.
All right, come on out here, man. Come back up. Opposite side. All right, one more time, back up. All right, opposite side. All right, up. Opposite side. All right, up. One more time, down. Nice and easy. Not too much. Up. Last time, one more time, down. Okay, let's go. Step it tight.
Bounce.
Nice and easy, not too much. Don't put too much on it. Try to watch yourself.
Work your arms.
Watch out, Shamorie. Okay. Back up some, back up some. Let Shamorie and them get off the thing. All right, move your arms. Get your arms involved. Come on, Slim. I don't like the way you're pushing off. Switch. Come on, Mally. One more time, last time. Switch. Most important thing, man, we've been here before. We know this situation all too well. You know what I'm saying? We wait for this opportunity to get a chance to show them who's the best, man. Everybody talking a whole bunch of man, but we can really leave it all out on the court to show them guys that we better than them. You know, you guys got opportunity to do something that we haven't done in a while. All you big guys got to box out, you got to play tough. Everybody must be their brother's keeper. Go to the bathroom. Okay, we up. Simple, simple. Hands up. Take advantage of the opportunity. You big guys, you got to be tough. Got to be determined. You got to be aggressive. Will not be denied. Cannot allow these guys to have their way with you. Everybody must get back. Everybody must help. We control the boards, we control the game. Down. Up. Down. Up. Down. Same way, Rock. Guys, there ain't no time to cut no corners.
Give me what I ask.
Nice and slow. Good.
Same room. Straight to the room. Let's go. Take it easy, Slim.
Let's go.
So you ready? The more I see the Madison Square Garden, that's what it is.
You just take it up, man.
How long does it take you to get dressed? You've been getting dressed and tucking and you still are sloppy. Like 10 minutes, the sky's the bozo, man. Mal, you locked in and focused? Who's here, the beast? Or the other person?
The hungry beast.
Oh, nah. I want a hungry
beast.
Beast
from San Diego,
man. I want a hungry beast.
I'm hungry.
You hungry today? Sun is shining. Blessed day, all you guys are healthy.
Come on.
You should be happy. Slide down, Kay. Kay, come out the closet. Come on. Man. Senior year, last game. Come out the corner, Kay. Come out the corner. Come out the corner, Kay. All right? You know what I'm saying? When you a senior, Kay, you should be sitting right here. Ready, coach. I'm locked in, ready. You in the back like coach. I don't want no part of the fire. Let me know, Kay.
You the softest guy from Red Hook I ever met in my life. Come on, sit right here, Kay. Let me know you're ready. Sit over here, man. I'm supposed to put the freshman back there. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, freshman, get out of here, man. I'm already locked in, man. I'm going in that fire today. Hey, guys, more importantly, you know, a lot of teams would love to be in your position right now. You know? You guys got a shot on Championship Saturday at Madison Square Garden. You know, more importantly, have fun, man. All the seniors going to get in there, you know? So be ready. Be locked and loaded. Touch that guard on court. You underclassmen that, you know,
okay,
if I can't get you in there, guess what? You guys got next year to get here and do your thing when the seniors leave. So that's number. That's next. Be cheering for the guys. Play this game like your last, because it could be your last, but more likely it's your last week of basketball. If you win today, we got one more week left. So just lay it all out there, man. You guys had a great season. Unfortunately, the standards have been set real high for us in our program, and this is one thing that's been hovering over our head, that we don't have this one goal, this one thing out there. But no matter what happens today, you guys are all winners, man. You know, so you guys have been winning for your whole career. You guys have been fighting. But it's your time, man. And I love you guys. I can give you all the snacks and Gatorades in the world. Or whatever I can give, I can give. All the Chinese food, all the Franks, the peanut butter jelly sandwiches. But I can't give you that championship, man. You gotta go out there and play on your home court and shake out. Chi, Ra, y'all gotta make it happen, man. I can't get that for you. Unfortunately, they want it too. You know, those guys are your friends. Those are nice guys. You kids are nice guys. When you get out on that court, man, this is business. It ain't personal. It's not personal. This is business. So, forwards, don't give up any layups or easy baskets. Let's run and get back on defense. Guard, stop the ball. But more important, let's be the aggressors and attack. You know what I'm saying? Our history this year has been coming out, getting late starts, and then turning it up later, Shamorie, especially you and Rob. We don't need to. This is not a game. And that court is in a bubble championship when you play against a well-coached, good team like Lincoln, who's confident, he's used to winning these things. You know, they're gonna come out of the gate ready to fight, ready to knock you down. Soon, and we're going to get down and can't recover. So don't worry about who's reffing the game. Don't worry about none of that stuff, guys. Just worry about on the court, stopping guys, rebounding, and taking it to the basket. You guys got anything to say? I'm gonna coach you guys today, but this is no different than any other game. But I'm gonna say less, but it's up to today, because championship side, it's up to you guys to do more. You know what I'm saying? All the stuff that we ask you guys to do is prepare you for this moment right here. So nothing else matters. You guys, again, 23-8, one of the better teams in and around this tri-state in the country. You guys seem the best, so to be the best today, 32 minutes is in your way, guys. All right, bring it in, guys. 32 minutes.
Go back, Malik.
that's good. Tyler, two lines. Penetrate, kick out. In the middle.
Thank you.
Like this and Tyler right there. You just let them attack the gap. So we don't want to give them no gaps in the 23. For one, we just want to, once we show 23, then once you take the ball, we match up. Lastly, we gotta run transition, Slick. You have to dribble the ball up here. Transition.
Yo, let's go. One more.
Come on.
Slick. Slick, my machine is on. CJ. Yo, y'all gotta bring us home, yo. CJ, bring us home.
Thank you. not Kaheem. You deny him. When the shot go up, you face guarding and boxing him out. Y'all not doing that. Why won't y'all do that, Slick? Why won't y'all listen, man?
Don't listen, man. We got 8 minutes. 8 minutes, man. Let's go, man. 8 minutes. 8 minutes, yo. Slick, CJ, and Watson, y'all gotta lead them. Y'all gotta win the game in 8 minutes. Y'all champions. That's all y'all gotta remember. So we gotta win this quarter. We all gotta fight, man.
Big dog!
Hey, hey, get the coach. Get the coach crying. Get the coach crying. You can't get the coach crying. Yo, we 40 people.
Yes, sir.
Oh, you did it, man.
Oh, you did it. Great game, great game.
Shamorie, you did it, baby. You did it, kid. Good looking out, baby.
Good luck at St. John's.
I know. Shamorie, what does that mean? I'm not Michael, I'm Jordan. What does that mean?
I don't know.
Congratulations, bro.
You got it on.
Coming back to Brooklyn, boys and girls, PSAL, city champions, coming back to Brooklyn. We're going to bring the states home, too. Appreciate you. Under Armour took over the Garden, seeing Hall do it tonight.
Okay, we got Buffalo Bills no more, right?
Yeah, I know, right? Can't call us that, man.
Great game, boy. Thanks, little homie. Congratulations, my man. Great game.
I'm on these guys because I want them to do well. And I was a little under the weather this week. I'm still under the weather. So I kind of put a lot of things in those two guys' hands. I said, if you guys are going to win a championship, you know, you got to prepare for it. And they practiced like champions all week. They rallied up the guys, and they executed. I mean, we said there was going to double Shamorie coming out. Out of the gate, Rasheen is going to have to step up and put his foot on those guys, put his foot on the gas, and he did exactly that. He started the game out, Shamorie finishing together, those two guys closed out. And it's so fair that these guys went to school together since they were in first grade, never been apart. And you know, one guy's going to St. Francis, one guy's going to St. John's. I think the Saints was in the building today. So I was just happy for those guys. When they came in, they won the JV City Championship freshmen. And they go out as city champions and seniors. And it's just a great story. Two guys, both have scholarships, both qualified to go to college. I mean, one more. I mean, it's been a great year. It's one of the best years since I've been part of teaching. Not even at Jefferson, just the story, all success these guys had, we play a tough schedule all over the country. These guys just to represent for New York and for Brooklyn.
Some questions for the student athletes.
I mean, it feels very great. I mean, I worked all year for this. Me and my team, we wanted to battle. I mean, we put time, effort, dedication, and we just wanted to get the win, get our coach's first ring, break history.
I mean, it's exciting to get this ring, to get a point, to get one for coach. Us coming in as one, leaving out as one. I'm just excited.
Each other, we love each other. I mean, us not knowing that we're not gonna play with each other next year, and us having grown that young man, I know we have to do that, but I mean, it's my brother since young, so it's like, oh, we know it's what we know. We got a lot of chemistry together.
So. It was a lot of emotions, crying, telling each other we love him. I mean, we said we're gonna get one, we're gonna, yeah, we got it.
Yeah, these two guys they brought a tear to my eye because these two guys are close. I think they're closer to each other than I think they own biological brothers and sisters. And these two guys together, if you need looking for one, the other one's right with them. So these guys don't do anything without each other. But for 4 years and see where they came from and where they are right now today is just it's a great story. A lot of kids look up to them. So Could have wrote a better script.
Coach, three times in the past, you've been on the other side of this. Now here you are on the stage as the champ. Is it everything you expected it was going to be?
Not really. I mean, it hurts more losing than the hurt of losing is more than the joy of winning. I mean, it didn't sink in yet, but it hurts to lose. I mean, when you win, you know, it's like you just got to get ready for practice the next day. And you have a little bit of time to celebrate tonight, but Monday we have practice and get ready to go upstate to win the state championship. So I told the guys, it's a great win today, but I'm greedy. I want to win it all. I want to win the state because, you know, I got one more week with you guys. I'm going to enjoy it, spend every day with it. It's our last week together with coaching these guys. And next year I'll be here in the garden watching those guys play against each other. The good thing they're both going to be wearing red, so I can wear red. I can wear red to the game. So.
I mean, it was like when we started the game, I was like kind of nervous, but as the game flowed, I like the nerves just got out, and I just played my game.
Rasheem, you had a degree right at the start. You kind of turned around and looked at Lincoln's bench. Did you say anything to them at that point? Did you kind of know this was gonna happen?
I said what? Cause I shot the board. He said that's off, and then when they turned around, I said what? I mean, I think they did a good job motivating Rasheem. Rasheem, I mean, they don't guard him. They feel that he's not gonna be productive and don't guard him. So that's been, but he stepped up. At our school, he had 30. At in the Borough Championship, he had 30. Of course, I pulled a Popovich, a Buttovich at Lincoln, and he didn't play at Lincoln, but he's averaged 30 points against those guys. So hopefully next year he guard our guys the same way. You know, and Rasheem he takes that personal. So when he hit that three, and he turned and looked, I knew what he was saying. Like, what? I'm gonna be ready. I'm gonna be ready, lock and load, and shoot the ball. So that's good, man. I mean, you gotta respect this guy. Scott's a Division I player. He didn't got 30 the last two times against you, and you still don't want to guard the guy. But I mean, I guess everybody has their own way of doing things. But Rasheem did what he had to do.
Trying to let this all sink in and stuff, but I saw you get a little emotional just before. Is it just all this, all the pressure and everything? Is that great for you to let it all go and enjoy
it? Yeah, I mean, it's not everybody, all the fans, people in Brownsville and Eastern York, they on my back every day about this championship. So I said, guys, when I first came to Jeff, we didn't even have a basketball. You know, we didn't have a basketball. Don't forget where we came from. And I said, guys, I'm a winner. I'm gonna win. These guys are winning. These guys guys are going to school for free with using basketball. I got a bachelor's and a master's from West Virginia using basketball. I'm a winner. I'm winning 25 games a year. We travel around the country. I mean, don't let the championship determine how successful our program and I am as a coach. But, of course, if you don't have that thing there, man, you suck. I'm the worst guy in the world. You know, I'm the bad guy. So people forget. But anyway, nobody wanted this job 12 years ago. You couldn't give this job away. Now everybody's telling me how to coach, what to do, what I'm not doing. But, I mean, I guess that goes with the territory, and we've done a lot of winning, and we set the standard so high that it's the only thing people could say about us in our program. Even Tiny, even after the game, when Tiny was shaking hands, he said, it's about time, Bozo. So I guess the Bozos is out of the Bozos time today. So, hey, it is what it is.
Coach, can you speak for a second on just how good Shamorie could be at St. John's? Do you see him maybe competing for the rookie of the year next year?
Shamorie could be good. I mean, I think, not just talking about Shamorie. I mean, just look at what Whitehead, those guys from Brooklyn did. Last night on my Instagram, a lot of people was mad at me. I put on my Instagram a picture of those Kadeem, Whitehead. I was texting Whitehead. I was so happy to see those guys doing what they do. Those are Brooklyn guys. New York City guys. People say New York City is down. We don't have players. You see what those guys are doing last night? How can you not be a fan of that? So I think there's plenty more guys like that around New York City if they get the chance. I don't think that people gave Desi a chance. I think Desi went along with the Whitehead package deal and Tiny, but I mean, I don't think they knew how good he was. He's a double figure Big East player as a sophomore. So I think Shamorie has that potential. I tagged him on the picture and I said, hey, you up next. You up next, Shamorie. So I think he has a lot of potential. He got a lot of guys coming in with him. So he should be ready.
How does it feel to finally win a championship and how big is this for the school?
It's big for the school. I mean, it's good. We just got our gym done over, so I moved. We had that banner from 1954, so I said, I got to try something different. I said, when you paint the gym, put that banner to the left, and we're going to leave that spot for the right for the new one. I hope that worked. So we got a spot for it, and I'm happy because I'm tired of people talking about 1954. And I don't know what happened in 1954, but I know right now, 2016, we're the champs. So, I'm enjoying this summer.
Shamar and Rasheem, when as players, besides stepping on the court and having that confidence during the game, that you feel this is over, there's no way they are coming back to beating us?
We just communicated. If we was talking to each other on the court, like us, the past game, we wasn't usually talking. When we was playing the league in our boroughs, we wasn't really talking. But we came together as one, and we got the job done.
Shamar, you obviously have a big mutual respect. How much has your relationship grown with the St. John's coaching staff since you've committed, even more than beforehand? And second, do you watch guys at Seton Hall and use that as motivation going into the next year and playing in the Big East?
Well, our relationship with Coach Mullen, Matt, Slice, it's like a family. And going to the next year, watching the St. Hall, I just want to come in and do the same thing, or do even better.
Last question.
You scored 8 points in 37 seconds. Shot
one
that was practically in a fresh
metal.
Were you just feeling like you had so much confidence? You feel like you couldn't miss?
It was just a lot. I just scored and I was just feeling it, so I just let it go.
You guys got a little emotional after the co-MVP thing. What was going through your head? What did you guys say to each other?
We were just telling each other we love each other and that we did it. We finally got what we wanted.
How important was it for you guys to get Bud this title?
It was very important, especially coming in together as one, even now as one.
For you, as we were talking about just in there, the whole St. John's thing, getting ready. I know you got at least one more game here with Jeff before we get there, but what was it like having a game like that here? Where are you going to play next year?
It's big. It's big having a game like that to show the St. John's fans what I could possibly do next year. Just showing them a bit.
Do you have any expectations for what the federations are going to be like?
I have no idea. I'm just going to go practice on Monday and see what we got in store.
We just told each other we came in and won the JV City Chip, so let's just go out seniors and win the varsity City Chip.
seemed like you and Rasheem were kind of loose there. Kind of, you know, you guys were very confident. Did you guys feel confident you could bounce back from the last time you lost the Lincoln?
Yes, we were very confident. And it started from the gym. We were just in the gym working, motivating the team. And we obviously came out here and got the job done.
People underestimate just how good Rasheem is and the energy he brings and both sides of the floor, just how good he was in this game.
He was terrific. I think he should just got the MVP by himself because he started it. He started the game out. I mean, if it wasn't for him, probably the game would have been close for me because he started the game. Like he had 13.5, and he got us going. Like he motivated the team.
Just the start of that third quarter. I mean, you got 18 straight points almost. What was really cooking for you guys out there?
We were just confident. Coach thought they didn't shoot. Like he just give us the green light to just shoot.
St. John's.
As you said, you had a lot. You had Chris Mullen in the building. You had Matt Albusine in the building. A lot of St. John's people. I saw you hug Matt. Just what did he say to you?
He said you finally got one. Congratulations. Nah, I told him I appreciate it.
I feel like you really want to come here next year and improve it for him and show what you did tonight.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah. Last question. With a bud, I mean, this is, he has so much pressure over the years. He's saying you can't win this or whatever. Buffalo Bills, just how good is it for you guys to help him win this championship?
I mean, it was important for Bud to get this chip as it's going out. I mean, he wanted it real bad. He said, but he can't want it more than us. So we just was hungry.
Huh? Thanks, man. Jamal, congratulations.
Thank you.
Absolutely, man. Good job, man.
Good luck.
Thanks, man.
Good luck. Thanks. We'll see you next week. I'm starting.
Yo, sir. Yo, where food at?
Yo, bro. Yo. Grass, man. You know how we do.
Took care of business, man. JV up next, man. You know that.